when the EPP started last week, but it was a, you know, rather than nets and batting practice, it was the Apprentice. I mean, how did you find that?
Yeah, no, it's different, obviously. To be tucked up in a suit for 3 days is a bit strange. But the lads put all their effort into it. I think most days were 6:30 in the morning to about 9:30 at night, working through dinner. So we got to know what the other half lived like. But no, it's real good.
What was the task that you guys got set?
We were tasked to put together a marketing campaign to improve LVV Cancer Championship attendance and following. We got 3 days for that, and I don't think we had quite enough time.
And who was your team?
My team was James Harris, Chris Wright, and Azeem Rafiq.
And you know, who was captain, and you know, what was your basic plan?
Yeah, no, James Harris took the captaincy. I think it was always going to be him, so no, he did a very good job. And our plan, we tried to get as many kids in as possible because we think that's the next generation. Obviously, we wanted as many people playing cricket as well as attending. So we put little camps, regimes, that sort of thing in place. And then we also went down the usual route, designed the website, tried to make the ECB people happy, saying how good their website is, all this sort of stuff. So, no. But yeah, we tried to explore a few avenues.
And then obviously you had to present it. How was that?
Yeah, no, we had an idea two of our guys would present, James Harris and Chris Wright. And then Azeem Rafiq popped in on their presenting as well last minute, so it was just me stuck there pushing a button. But they did a really good job, to be fair.
And you had David Parsons, performance director, as Alan Sugar. How was he?
I think he was a bit harsher than Alan Sugar, to be honest. He had me shaking. A few of the boys were a little bit nervous having to talk to him. He probably got stuck into us.
And of the three groups you guys won, how pleased were you?
Yeah, I think it was always going to happen, to be honest. After our initial ideas and looking at a few of the other groups, they hadn't actually worked out what we had to do by day one. I think we were front runners from early on.
Did you think it was a worthwhile exercise?
I think definitely. Obviously, you worked in a small group, but it brought you closer to those three guys you were with, especially for me, who hadn't come across the likes of Azeem and James before. To be able to work with them for 3 days really, really got us a lot tighter.
I suppose also the chance to sort of work in a non-cricketing environment too.
Yeah, no, it's different. Obviously, this is where we feel comfortable. But to get us out of that comfort zone, having to work on something and put our minds to something for that amount of hours in a day was challenging. But I think obviously when we won it, it was very rewarding.
I suppose also the, you know, teamwork and being dynamic. I mean, those are elements that you need in cricket too.
Yeah, definitely. I think within cricket, they're quite easy to show those sorts of traits. But I think if you can try and demonstrate them outside in a boardroom sort of situation, then they're going to really come through, especially strong when you get into your comfortable environment as well.
And will you be ditching the wicket-keeping gloves for a suit?
I don't think I will. I think a couple of our team might be. James Harris shaped up quite well in a suit. And Chris Wright enjoyed it as well. I couldn't wait to get out of it though myself.